See, last class we were discussing about the ports, harbors, major port, minor port. This class we will continue the layout of other ports. We have seen Chennai port last class. This class we will discuss other ports like Ennore port, Tuticorin port, Kandla port, Jawaharlal Nehru port, etc. Yesterday I have shown you this map, India map, showing the ports on the eastern side as well as ports on the western side. I want to discuss about artificial and natural harbors, showing the layout. Most of the ports on the east coast are artificial harbors. And most of the ports on the west coast are natural harbors. Natural harbor means generally there won't be any breakwater. Natural configuration of the sea provides tranquility. Tranquility means reduced wave height within the harbor area. Reduced wave height means generally less than 0.5 meters. Last class we have seen the Chennai port. I am again repeating this Chennai port layout in the context of artificial harbor. So we have built the breakwaters on the eastern side as well as on the northern side. So these breakwaters provide tranquility inside the harbor area. So the tranquility means when outside 5 meter wave height is there, generally inside only 10% of the waves penetrate. How the waves penetrate? When the waves come from different directions, there is an opening through which wave comes inside. Even if there is a wave coming from this side, there is what is known as diffraction, and waves coming from this side gets diffracted and comes inside. But when the waves are coming from this side, it will directly penetrate the harbor. And since the width of the opening is limited, the waves will not come throughout the opening here because this portion is protected. Only this opening is there and through which only waves will penetrate. So we have shown the northern direction here like this. Generally we have three monsoons in India. One is called as the northeast monsoon, another is called as the southwest monsoon, the third is called as the non monsoon. So when you have different monsoons, the wave directions will be different. Southwest monsoon predominantly wave direction will be like this, northeast monsoon wave direction is like this. Northeast monsoon is generally for 3 months, starting from October, November and December. Non-monsoon is also for 3 months or 4 months, 3 to 4 months, January, February, March, April. Then we have the remaining 5 months where we will have the southwest monsoon, that is May, June, July, August and September. So one of the problems of artificial harbor by constructing the breakwater is when the waves are coming in this direction, it carries certain sand along with that, the water. So the breakwater arrests the sand movement and deposition take place. You have very good Marina Beach on the southern side. Since the northern side is starved of sediment, we will have erosion on the northern side. This is during southwest monsoon. During northeast monsoon, this side will get deposited and this side will get eroded. Predominantly the wave climate is more during southwest monsoon. Consistently only occasionally in northeast monsoon we will have cyclones, and that time the wave height is very high. So, the net movement is from south to north, getting deposited and forming Marina Beach. So, this is one of the important consideration when you build a artificial harbor, that is environmental management, talking about coastal process and shoreline evaluation. So, we will discuss that in one of the lectures about this. So, this to cap what we have discussed in the last class, we have discussed that Chennai port has three docks, Jawahar dock, Ambedkar dock, Bharathi dock. The wave climate inside Jawahar dock is much less compared to Ambedkar dock, and Bharathi dock will have slightly higher wave climate than Ambedkar dock. The water depth is more in Bharathi dock. They are increasing the water depth inside the Ambedkar dock as well as the Jawahar dock to receive bigger size vessels. And to keep pace with the development in the world, because the ships are coming from ports from abroad to India. So, in abroad if we have a deeper draft, in India also we have to create deeper draft. So, we have vessels normally used for container about 4500 TEU vessel. The 4500 TEU vessel can be berthed in the first container terminal, which is a public private partnership scheme with the DP World, as well as the second container terminal, which is developed by Port of Singapore Authorities Limited. When you have more than 4500 TEU, now there is a possibility to go up to 18,000 TEU. We need the bigger draft up to 18 meters. So, it is proposed to build a terminal here. Last class I told this as a transshipment terminal, that means 18,000 TEU vessel will come and berth here. They will unload the containers, then smaller container vessels starting from 600 TEU to 4500 TEU will come and take the containers from here, and it will move to all along the east or west coast or other countries. So, this container berth length is around 2 kilometers. We have to discuss about the capacity of the berth. The capacity of the berth is generally about 1500 TEU per meter length per year. That means, if we have 2 kilometer long berth into 1500 TEU, it comes about 3 million TEU, that is the capacity of the berth. But this is on a lower side, 1500 TEU. With the increased number of cranes on the berth, we can increase to 2000 TEU. 2000 TEU is generally the benchmark for good operation and management. In that case, this facility for 2 kilometers will handle about, from here to here 2 kilometers will handle about 4 million TEU. One of the advantage of a transshipment terminal is, when you unload about 1 million TEU, you load again 1 million TEU. That means, the same container you are operating twice. That means, it becomes 1 million TEU becomes 2 million TEU. Singapore is a very big transshipment terminal. Most of our containers to India is coming from Singapore, because they have very good operational facility. One more factor that is to be considered when you discuss about the port development is berth occupancy ratio. The berth occupancy ratio is defined as number of days the ships are in the berth divided by the total number of days available for berthing. Generally, the berth occupancy ratio should be about 0.5 to 0.6. In India, it is very high, very high means it may go even up to 0.8, 0.9, but that is not good because the ship have to wait outside because of non availability of berth. Whereas in Singapore berth occupancy ratio is very close to 0.5, that means the berth is always available for the ship to come. So we are trying to achieve that so that the ships will not be standing outside, the berth will be available here as soon as the ship comes very close to the port limits. I will discuss about port limits in another slide. Nowadays with the satellite imagery we get very good pictures of the ports. If we see the previous port, the entrance is from the north eastern side, this is for Chennai port. Whereas if we see the Ennore port, north is this direction, your entrance is coming from the southern side, southeastern side. So the entrance is one of the important consideration for designing the port layout. They are specifying this southern entrance mainly because they have lot of shoals. Shoals means sand deposits here, so the water depth is very shallow here. If you keep the opening from this side, they have to do lot of maintenance dredging. So we will discuss about two types of dredging. One is called as a capital dredging. Once you develop the port inside the harbor basin, this area as well as the entrance channel, over a period of time, since we have increased the depth inside as well as outside compared to the places adjacent, whenever the movement of wave transport sediments, since the depth is more here, the velocity becomes less and it gets sedimented. Point is clear to you? You have more depth here, more depth means area of cross section is more, the entrance channel. So the velocity becomes less and the water will get, when it is passing through this, the sediments in the water will get deposited here, and that we have to do maintenance dredging. Maintenance dredging is approximately about 10% of capital dredging. Suppose you dredge about 4 million cubic meter in the entrance channel as well as in the harbor basin, your maintenance dredging will be about 0.4 million cubic meter. If you see the layout here, this is your shoreline. We have one breakwater here and we have another breakwater here. The entrance is from this side, this is your north side, this is your east side. Generally we have to show the port layout in this configuration only. What is that you are seeing here, this portion? What do you think it is? Sedimentation. So this I told you in the previous slide that because of the movement of waves, the wave may act like this in this direction, that is from here to here. This will have two components, one is called as the alongshore component, another is called as onshore offshore component. Once you have the alongshore component, it carries some sediment along with this. Once you have a breakwater here like this, the sediment get deposited. Original coastline was here, this was the original coastline. Over a period of time, this much portion get deposited. As you are building the breakwater, the sediment also gets filled up. You have to continuously build the breakwater, otherwise the sediment, if you stop and then start like that, whatever sediment you are coming here, it will come up to this entrance, then it will bypass, that is not desirable. Okay. So this distance is I think approximately about 600 or 700 meters and this distance is about 400 meters, but this will reach certain equilibrium. As much you are getting this sedimentation northern side, there will be erosion. But northern side already shoal is there, that will get eroded. Then when you do the capital dredging, another environmental impact assessment is where you are disposing of the dredged material. You can put it on the northern side assuming that there will be erosion and it will be taken away, it is called as a landfill. Or you can dispose of the dredged material at deeper waters in about 30 meter water depth, because in 30 meter water depth, if you 30 to 50 meter water depth, if you dispose of whatever you are disposing from here to here will not come back to the shore. So normally in maintenance dredging they do not dispose at correct point, so whatever they are depositing will come back to the entrance channel as well as inside the harbor basin. So you should see what you are dredging is disposed of properly. We have to do some studies to find out where it can be effectively disposed. Here what you have is a coal terminal which is used by Tamil Nadu Electricity Board, and here we have a temporary jetty where they are using the iron ore export. This is a temporary, they have removed it, now they are trying to build a new facility here. And this is your POL berth. What is POL?
Petroleum oil
and lubricant. So this is called as a POL berth, and POL berth is very long berth. This can handle from a smaller vessels to a bigger vessel. Smaller vessel means 5000 DWT to up to 100,000 DWT, right. So they have a continuous berth here. We will discuss about layout of berth later, but here it is a continuous berth. Normally POL berths are with dolphins and isolated structures, but here it is continuous to take care of smaller to longer vessels and more number of vessels also. What you are seeing is a pipeline trestle through which the pipelines are used to transport the cargo on top of the piles to the land area. And typically this breakwater, one of the breakwaters will be longer compared to another breakwater, because one of the critical problem for ship approach is, suppose a ship is coming here in the outside, completely outside, all the portion of the ship will be subjected to same waves and currents. Suppose it has come inside, waves are less, but suppose 50% of the ship is this side and 50% of the ship is this side, the waves will be more on the exposed area beyond the breakwater and less on this. That will try to shift the ship like this, instead of the ship going like this, it will go like this. That is why we have to be very careful in designing this, and once it comes here, it will get good tranquility. This is another study which you have to do, that is called as ship maneuvering, how you are bringing the ship here. Last class I told that ship will be stopped somewhere here, then it takes a stopping distance, this is called as a stopping distance, that is equal to 7 times the length of the ship. Then the tugboats are connected here itself, but when the ship stops, then it will turn the vessel and bring the vessel very close to the berth. Now there is a lot of development in Ennore port. They are building a car terminal here, that is not shown here. They are also building a container terminal here. This is called as Ennore Port Limited. This is called as Landlord Port. Landlord Port means Ennore Port Limited has built only the breakwater. They have done capital dredging, they have done the maintenance dredging. Here there are three arms shown here. These are used for the tugboats to berth at this location. So they are maintaining the tugboats, maintaining the channel and maintaining the harbor basin, whereas the berths are built in public private partnership, and this is done by one company called IMC. This is for TNEB. container berth has gone into a consortium of some foreign companies and Indian companies. So the landlord port means only the breakwaters, the dredging and operation of vessel using the tugboats will be done by the Ennore Port Limited, whereas the terminals, this is the coal terminal, POL terminal, will be operated by the PPP operator. Terminal means they will have the berthing structures, they will have the cranes, and they also will have a conveyor. There will be a conveyor which will be transporting the cargo to the stackyard. The stackyard also will have stacker and reclaimer. When you talk about port engineering, it is not civil engineering alone, it is a mechanical engineering also is there, in the sense that all the mechanical handling systems should be of high quality, maintenance free, as well as high capacity of loading and unloading. The loading and unloading is about 2000 tons per hour approximately. 2000 tons per hour means 20 hours of operation, you will get about 40,000 tons per day. Typically Panamax size vessel will have 60,000 DWT. That means the Panamax size vessel, 60,000 tons of cargo can be handled in 1.5 days. Is it clear? 2000 tons per hour, 20 days, 40,000 tons per day, 20 hours of operation. If you take 1.5 days, 60,000 tons of vessels will be evacuated within a 1.5 days. We have this is called as an unloading terminal. Unloading means the coal is coming from Paradip or somewhere else, Indonesia or other countries, then it is unloaded and it is taken into this. So if there is a port in Indonesia or Paradip in Orissa, that is called as a loading port. Which rate will be higher, loading rate or unloading rate? Unloading rate is wrong answer. Loading rate is the right answer. Unloading rate means from the ship you have to pick up the cargo. Loading means from the berth you are loading into the ship. Suppose you put the cargo, it is faster. You take the cargo. Suppose I put 1 kg of rice, I can put it very fast. If I take 1 kg of rice, it will take more time. Another thing is I cannot take 1 kg of rice. Even by hand if you are taking, no? 1 kg of rice if I want to take, only 900 grams I will be able to take, 100 grams will be lying here. To take first 500 grams it will be faster, then another 200 grams it will be slower. The last 100 grams will be very difficult. Same thing happens in the ship also. The unloading rate is not uniform. This point is clear. When the ship is full with the cargo, then you can, unloading rate will be faster. When the cargo is getting reduced and reduced, removing the cargo will become a problem. So loading rate is generally higher, it is about 2500 to 3000 tons per hour. It depends on the type of cargo also, density of the cargo. What is the density of cargo? What will be the density of coal and what will be the density of iron ore? Which will be higher? What will be the density? 7.6 to 7. That is the density of the metal, not the ore. Iron ore means it is a bulk density. It will be only around 2.2 iron ore. Coal will be very close to 1. Understood? No, density means you are thinking of the density of metal. It is not density of metal, it is density of material, bulk density it is called. Then we will go to Cochin port. So Cochin port, just like previous, I have given the latitude and longitude, and again this is connected to the hinterland, to Kerala, South Tamil Nadu and South Karnataka. The connectivity is important. National highways NH-47, NH-49, NH-70. There are three NH, Kanyakumari-Salem, Cochin Madurai, Cochin Mumbai. So any port need to have a connectivity, this is very important. So port development means it is not the development of the port only, it is the development of hinterland also. And any port is not state dependent, it is covering Kerala, South Tamil Nadu and South Karnataka also, not one state alone. Even if it is minor port under state control, it will attract cargo from neighboring states. This shows the layout of Cochin port. This is the entrance channel. We have two channels here. One is called as the Ullar Bottom channel, another is called as the Ernakulam channel. This is natural backwaters, natural channels for entering. There is no breakwaters. This is on the east coast, this is on the west coast, ideal location, no breakwaters are here. Just like unlike Ennur and Chennai, because we are able to maintain the channel with the dredging, the siltation is not much. We are discussing about Ullar Bottom container terminal last class. This is the location of the Ullar Bottom terminal. We have one more island here called, it is called as Puduvaipin Island. This Puduvaipin Island means, Pudu means new in Tamil as well as in Malayalam. This Puduvaipin Island is formed because of the sediment deposition here. Original coastline was somewhere here and now we have formed the new island here. We are here, we have a oil terminal and we also have what is called as Puduvaipin SEZ. SEZ means special economic zone. So here we get lot of concession and new industries are developed. And this island is called as the Wellington Island. The real estate prices are very high, very close to the port, in any port city. It is not the Mount Road or Besant Nagar which is very costly in Chennai city. It is the land area adjacent to the port. Similarly in Cochin, Wellington Island is very expensive area. To get the land in Wellington Island for temporary container facilities, handling facilities, is very expensive. Here also you can see some of the bridges which are being built for taking the cargo. Any doubts in this? This is the Arabian Sea. There is no breakwater. Natural opening is there. One other thing is this opening should be natural, not on the seaside. Between the sea and the land area, lot of water area is there. All the water coming to Kerala state, they get drained out, and due to tidal variation also water goes into this channel. We have the berthing structures all along this as well as along this. We have a shipyard also in this Cochin port, and we have certain naval facilities also in Cochin port. This shows the layout. This is called as Mattanchery, Fort Cochin. This is how the vessels normally go inside the channel. This is the naval area. This is a 500 meter turning circle. This is called as the Ernakulam channel. There are many facilities here on this side also. Tourists come through this side and they can also go all the way to Fort Cochin. And this is the location for Ullar Bottom channel. This shows the northern direction. Then we will see next JNPT, the Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust, the latitude, longitude is given. This port is handling mostly container and we also have a liquid terminal. We also have a shallow water berth where we use the break bulk and container traffic. Break bulk means coal, iron ore and things like that, but mostly JNPT is handling only container traffic. This gives the overall picture of the Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust, but you please concentrate on this area. This is the entrance channel through which the vessels will come and go all the way. Then there is a turning circle, it will come back. This is showing the berth areas. Mostly these are all container berths. Here we have some terminals where oil can be handled. These are showing some future developments. Here also certain approaches and new developments that will take place. If you see here, one of the features of JNPT is we have the berths all along this, far away from the shoreline. Shoreline is somewhere here. So, it is one of the new concept. There is an approach from the shoreline to the berth. Normally this is used only for liquid terminals, but now they are using it for container terminal also, because the water depth is available only here. If you place this berth along this, lot of dredging is required and cost of berth also will be more, because this has to retain too much of soil. Here it will not retain the soil. They will dredge up to 14 meter. They will have about 200-300 meter distance, so that there will be a natural slope. And here you need only less funds for providing the retaining structures. They have written NSICT. This is one of the terminal which they have developed. The whole area is divided into two terminals. One is NICT, another is operated by Jawaharlal Nehru Port. What you are seeing is the Elephant Island. This Elephant Island is a natural formation, it is a historical place. And when they want to do the dredging here, they have to blast some rock. So, we have done some measurement on the caves, the Elephant Island, so that when you are blasting the rocks here, it does not have any blasting or dredging, does not have any impact on this. This is another factor that you have to consider. That is, three points I have told. Once you build a breakwater, there will be shoreline changes. You have to do the shoreline evaluation. Second one, I was talking about dredging. Dredging means capital as well as maintenance dredging. How you are dredging, how you are disposing of. Third one is, if the soil is consisting of rock, you may use some controlled blasting. And that operation is taking place, especially to the historical monuments, there should not be any damage. That also you have to study. This also is a natural harbor. Your Bombay Island is here, that gives protection to this. Elephant Island also gives protection to this. So, it is not directly facing the Arabian Sea. Arabian Sea is faced by Bombay Island here. So, it gives lot of protection to the JNPT. Next, we will see the port which is handling the maximum cargo in India. It is called as Kandla port. We have shown the latitude and longitude. You can go to the Google and see for this latitude and longitude how the layout is. And they have some major future plans. They want to build 4 dry cargo berths. Number is given as 13th to 16th. With 8 million metric tons per annum. So, MMTPA means million metric tons per annum. There are 4 berths, 13, 14, 15 and 16. Each berth they are given 2 million metric tons per annum. This capacity of 2 million metric tons per annum per berth, each of about 300 meter length, is less compared to other berths which are being used in Ennore or Chennai. There they may handle from 4 million tons to 6 million tons, because it is only single cargo, single commodity cargo. Ennore port, Tamil Nadu Electricity Board is having coal terminal, only coal is coming. It is coming in bigger vessel. They have very good handling system, conveyor system to take the cargo. Whereas here in Kandla, when you build the berth, you will have a general cargo only. You may get fertilizer, you may get rock phosphate, wheat, iron ore scrap, they may come in smaller vessels, that is why the handling rate is very less. They also want to build an offshore berthing facility with 12 million metric tons per annum at the cost of about 80-82 crores. It is at a satellite port which is called as Tuna with 15 meter draft, whereas here this draft will be about 14 meter. The cost is about 701 crores. 1 crore is 10 million rupees. This shows the layout of Kandla port. We have the Gulf of Kutch here, then we have a channel called as Sogal channel. This Sogal channel is coming here, America. The continuation of this portion is here. This is the long channel which goes here. In the layout of Kandla, this is called as a creek port, where the due to tidal waters, there will be movement of water in this direction during high tide, movement of water in this direction during low tide. We have shown here ebb and flood. So when there is a flood, that is high tide is there, water will go inside. When there is a ebb, there is a low tide, water will flow here. We have the bulk berths here on this side, and we have the oil berths here on the other side. If you see the layout of the port, you will always see that there will be well segregation between the liquid berths and other berths. Similarly, the container berths, clean cargo berths, and the dirty cargo berths. Here there is only one berth which is handling container, some 12th berth or so. All other berths are using different types of products. This Kandla port, there was a earthquake, some damage has taken place for about 6 berths. We will discuss about that later. Whenever there is a damage that is taking place due to earthquake or tsunami, we repair the berth, that is called as rehabilitation. We will discuss about that later. So here these are all the oil berths and these are all the dry berths. They are building 13, 14, 15, 16 like this. Then we will see the New Mangalore port. The New Mangalore port is also on the west side. This has about 14 berths, 9 general cargo berths and 4 oil jetties. This is handling liquid chemical through POL products, containers, bulk cargoes. Bulk cargoes consists of granite stones, timbers, coal, coke, iron ore pellets. We have a Kudremukh facility in near Mangalore. So this port is developed only to export of iron ore pellets, fertilizers. This is one of the largest LPG handling port in India. This is the third largest POL handling port in India. More than 50% of the cargo which is handled in the port is POL products. It is very important that POL facility is operational all along the coast of India, because distribution is a problem. If you do not have many facilities, at least every 200, 300 kilometers center to center, the distribution becomes a big problem. This is called as a lagoon harbor. We have a river called as a Kurupur river. This is the northern side, this is the western side. Lagoon means unlike Chennai or Ennore, we have the breakwaters to protect only the entrance channel. The port is developed in the land. This is called as a lagoon. We have created an artificial lagoon. This is your shoreline. The Kurupur river goes here and then it gets into sea after some distance. And we have built 2 breakwaters only to protect the entrance channel from siltation. There is a turning circle here. We have one set of berths here, another set of berths here handling the products other than POL. And these are the berths which are used for POL products. It includes LPG also. So this is located very close to the entrance, far away from this side, because if there is any fire hazard here, then it will not get distributed to these places. This is the berth used for iron ore. So when there is any vessel which has to be evacuated, the chemical tankers, POL product tankers, they can come very easily out. So, normally the liquid cargo facilities will be very near the entrance. So, with this we will complete today's lecture. We will discuss about other ports in the next class. Thank you.